In your starter code, you should see the Task Content Provider class in the Data folder. And if you open this up, you can see that this class extends from the Abstract Content Provider class in Android. And inside are six methods. You can see onCreate, insert, query, and a few others that we'll go over in a bit. Just know that all of these are required to build a complete content provider. In this starter code, these are all empty, or throw an exception, and it will be up to us to write code inside these six methods so that the provider actually works. And now that we have this basic structure, let's complete the first method, onCreate, which is called when the provider is initialized. In general, onCreate is where you should initialize anything you'll need to set up and access your underlying data source. In this case, the provider is working with an underlying SQLite database, so here's a good place to give it a way to open that database with a TaskDB helper object. So I'll first declare this helper as a member variable named mTaskDBHelper. Then, in onCreate, I'll assign this to a new TaskDB helper, passing in the context. First, I'll retrieve the context, which I have to import, then create the DB helper. And finally, instead of returning false, I'll return true, because this method is done. And this is one of the first steps in creating your own provider. But before we can start using it, we'll have to register it in the Android manifest.